All right, let's talk about Nmap and port scanning and what that's all about, because it's a really cool, but also a little bit scary thing, tool, stuff. And so we're gonna talk about what it is, what port scanning is, and why you should care. So in this video, we're gonna talk about what port scanning is, first of all, what information you can learn from port scanning, and then also how Nmap works to do some port scanning. I'll show you what a port scan looks like and what information we can learn from it. So port scanning is a way to find out what ports, specifically when we talk about ports, we're talking about transport layer, TCP, UDP, those ports, and typically with a focus on TCP because most services like HTTP, SSH, Telnet, all of those use TCP, so it's most, the TCP ports are the most interesting, but by far, they are not the only ports that are open or accessible on a machine, just the main focus because those are the services that are most interesting and also most likely to be attacked, which is a big reason why port scanning is a thing. So the purpose of port scanning is to figure out what ports are open and also what is running on those ports, specifically what services might be available, what services might be running on those ports. Because, as you know, ports, there's default ports for things. There's HTTP port 80, there's SSH for port 22 on all on TCP. There's HTTPS on 443, there's Telnet on 23, there's Doom on 666. All of those ports are the defaults, but services don't have to use the default port. And so you can use some probing tools to learn more about what's on the port than just what port it's on. Obviously, most often the default port's gonna have the default service. If you're on, if you see that port 22 is open, it's gonna have open SSH running on it, most likely, but not every time, as you know. So what can you learn about a computer from port scanning? You can learn what type of operating system it's running, because it turns out that when you're talking to a computer, Windows and Linux and Mac and different things, they talk slightly differently. And port scanning tools can use that information, use how they talk to figure out what operating system it is and potentially even what version of the operating system, again, depending on what you've got going on there. You can figure out what services are running. We've kind of talked about that a little bit. And you can even dig down to the point where you might be able to figure out exactly what version of specific software is running on a server. And that is hugely important and valuable information from a network mapping perspective, understanding what services are going on. If you control the network and have absolute control and can scan everything that's going on in the network, you might be able to detect rogue services. For example, in an enterprise network, you may not want people running web servers who aren't supposed to be running web servers. So you can use Nmap or other network mapping and port scanning tools to identify services that shouldn't be running that are running, or run it against your own servers to identify things that shouldn't be there but are there, and identify and gather more information about them so that you can go make that stop. So Nmap itself, and we'll talk about Zenmap a little bit too. Nmap is a network mapper. That's what Nmap stands for, and it's a tool to do this network mapping, including port scanning. And that's just one part of what it does, but it's the part we're gonna focus on here. It's a port scanning tool, and Zenmap is the graphical user interface to make it possible. You can run Nmap entirely from the command line. If you're gonna run Nmap against 1,000 different servers all at once, maybe you wanna do that from the command line, but for us, for our purposes, you can use the graphical user interface. It's a good way to get started and gives you some options, an easy way to do things. So now let's go to a demo. And one thing I wanna cover, just a slight disclaimer. Do not run Nmap against a service or site that you do not control or without explicit permission from whoever controls the site. You will or can get yourself blocked from those services. So if you try to run Nmap against google.com, Google's not going to be too happy about it, because when you're running a port scanner, you look like somebody who's getting ready to attack the service. So don't do that. All right, now let's get to the demo. All right, so I've opened up Zenmap on my computer, and you can see this is the interface, and it's really simple. Really, all it is a wrapper around the Nmap command to show you what you can do, with Nmap. And in fact, as you type, it's going to really show you exactly what the command is going to be. So the very first thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to select the option to do a quick scan, and I'm going to do it on basic.schetzler.net, which is my super simple website. And let's see what information we can get from a basic scan. So it's going to take a second. I'm going to make myself disappear so that we can see everything that here. And it shows us a very basic scan. Now, by default, Zenmap's not going to scan every single port on a computer because that's going to take a long time. There's potentially 65,535 of them, and each one of those takes a certain amount of time. What it does in something like a quick scan is scans the very basic services, the most likely ports to be open. For example, we see 2280, 443, potentially 8000, which is where a lot of development servers are. And we don't see a lot of information about those. So we can see, for example, that port 22 is open. It's probably running SSH. Port 80 is open. It's probably running HTTP, some sort of web service. And then 8000 is open. And you can see that 443, it thinks is sort of open, but it's closed. And what happened there is that I've got 443 open on the firewall, but there's nothing running on that port on the computer. So it can detect that I can try to get there and I can touch the computer on port 443, but I can't actually do anything. There's nothing there. So that is pretty much the extent of it. I can look maybe at host details and you can see there's not a lot there. It can see the domain names for that service, the number of scanned ports. It only scanned 100 out of those 65,535. So let's go back and now do a more intense scan. And the more intense scan is going to take a little bit longer. So I'm going to run this intense scan, and I'm going to pause while the intense scan completes because it takes a little bit longer than the quick scan does, but we're going to have more information to see at the end. All right, now that's complete. So let's go back and look and see what's there. So for one, it ran a whole bunch more tests. You can see it took a lot longer. It's doing a whole lot more things and it's gathering a lot more information. So we can see the same ports and hosts, but instead of doing scanning 100 ports, I believe somewhere in here, it says that it scans at least 1,000 ports. Right here. You can see right here, it says that it scans 1,000 total ports. So again, this isn't every port. It's not 65,535. We could tell it to do that with other options, but that takes forever. And for no additional benefit in this case, because I know exactly what's running on that server, but these are the most common services. And we can look and see that we've got port 22, port 80, port 8000, and interestingly, this one has port 9090, which is it's a Python Echo server that I'm running on that computer that really doesn't do anything. And it isn't something that Nmap would recognize. And so it's misclassified it there as reverse SSL because it doesn't actually know. And I believe somewhere in this scan here, so it says port 22, we've got OpenSSH version 7.4. Port 80, we've got Apache HTTPD version 2.4.46. And it's got the supported methods, so a whole bunch of information there. Port 443 is closed. 8000 is another port that's running Apache, so the same information is there. And then 9090, it's saying, hey, I got some stuff here, and it says that this service is unrecognized despite returning data. So that's exactly what it is. It's this Python server that just provides an echo. It's nothing that Nmap would be familiar with, so it's saying, hey, I saw something here, I don't really know what it is. And then finally, we can look and see all that information here. And then we can look at host details and see that there's additional information, including what version of Linux it has. It hasn't detected that it's Amazon Linux per se. but it has detected some information. So play around with Nmap, do a port scan, look and see if there's additional information that I haven't shown. Maybe do an even more intense scan against all TCP ports or include UDP, or do a regular scan and see what the differences are between those. And you're welcome to do it against basic.schetzler.net. It's just gonna sit there doing nothing, nothing of high risk there. So feel free to attack, well, don't attack it, but feel free to hit it with that port scan. Okay, now that you've seen Nmap in action, let's talk about what you have learned. So first of all, what information can you learn using port scanning tools like Nmap or Zenmap? What information is there? And second of all, how can Nmap help attackers learn about a network? It's a valuable tool for good or ill. What do you need to be concerned about potential attackers learning about your network using tools like Nmap? Why does Google care so much that they will block you as soon as they detect that you start running port scanners against it? And that's that.